Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, our second video on conditional probability. Let's start with a question you should already know how to do from the first video. Pause the video and double check you can answer the following question. Okay, the key here was the fact that Paul was taking marbles out of the bag, but he does not replace them. That told us that we had to be very careful drawing our probability tree, and this was a conditional dependent type scenario. Hopefully you got the following probability tree. And what is the probability of two reds? You just had to multiply along the branches. It would have been 5/7 multiplied by 4/6, which is equal to 20 out of 42, which simplifies to 10 out of 21. Okay, now in this particular video, we're dealing with very similar cases, but more possible outcomes can occur, like the following example, which you should pause the video and have a go at. Okay, I'm just going to draw the probability tree. The key with these is to give yourself plenty of space. So off I go. And that is our complete probability tree to represent this situation. Now we may be asked some questions, and if you've got the probability tree, everything is nice and straightforward. So here are some of the questions we got asked. So what's the probability that they're the same colours? We look back at our probability tree and we say to ourselves, right, well, the scenario is either they're blue blue, or they can be red red, or they can be yellow yellow, and we combine those probabilities. So 6 add 12 is 18, add another 2 is 20 out of 72. So the probability there will be 20 out of 72, which simplifies dividing top and bottom by 4 to 5 over 18, and we're done. Now what's the probability of getting two different colours? Well, you could go and you could add up all the scenarios where they're different, which is this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one, and simplify. Or you could realise that they're either the yellow scenario, they're the same, or they're the green scenario where they're different. Because you know they're the same, the probability that they're the same already, you could just do one subtract that to give you what's left over, the green. So you could just use the answer in the previous one and say that the probability that they're different is 1 subtract the probability that they're the same, which is going to be 1 subtract 5/18, which is going to equal 13/18, and you're done. Alternatively, as I said, you could add up these probabilities and simplify, and you would get yourself 13/18 as before. Okay, next question. Pause the video and have a go. Okay, so here we go. Steve has 11 biscuits in a tin, so 11 in total. There are 6 digestives, 3 chocolates, and 2 ginger biscuits. It says Steve takes 2 biscuits at random from the tin. Work out the probability he chooses 2 different types of biscuit. Now, just a slight difference here. This isn't the scenario of taking marbles out of the bag where you take one and then take another one. You take maybe 2 biscuits at once. Now, to model this scenario, let's just imagine that there's a slight difference between the slight time difference between the time you take the first biscuit and the second biscuit, so you can model it as a probability tree. You may put your hand in and take them both out at the same time, but you can model that as taking one just ever so slightly before taking the other one, and that way the probability tree will help us work this out. Let's draw the picture, but give ourselves plenty of space, and I'm using the symbol D for digestive, C for chocolate, and G for ginger biscuit as follows. Okay, that's our probability tree with all the facts on it. Now, just to explain it quickly, in case there's any confusion, on the first pick, you either pick a digestive, a chocolate, or a ginger. There are six digestives out of 11, there are three chocolates out of 11, and there are two gingers out of 11, so hence the probability on the first pick. Now, assuming you go down this branch and you pick a digestive, let's think about it. The digestive number goes down from 6 to 5, and the overall digestive, the overall number of biscuits goes down to 10. So the probability of digestive given digestive is 5/10. The probability of chocolate given digestive, well, the chocolates are still 3, but there are now 10. The probability of ginger given digestive is now 2 out of 10. If, on the other hand, you chose a chocolate on your first pick, well, the number of biscuits are down to 10, but and the number of chocolates are now down to 2. Hence, the probability of chocolate given chocolate is 2/10, and the other ones are the same numbers as original, but out of 10, 6/10 and 2/10. In the third scenario, you pick a ginger on your first go, so the number of gingers go down from 2 to 1, and the number of biscuits go down to 10. So the probability of ginger given ginger is 1 out of 10, and the probability of the other ones are the original number, in the case of digestive, 6 out of 10, and chocolates, 3 out of 10. Here are all the probabilities as well worked out. The question asks us, however, what is the probability he chooses two different types of biscuit? So what's the probability he chooses two different types of biscuit? Well, here is the scenarios where there are different types of biscuit. Here, 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 and here. And you can add those probabilities up to work out what that is. But potentially, as I did in the last question, an easier way of doing it is to do 1 subtract the probability that the biscuits are the same, which I'm going to do in this one because I think it is slightly easier. So the probability that they're different is going to be 1 subtract the probability that they're the same. The things I've highlighted here in yellow, 30 add 6 is 36, add 2 is 38. So it's 1 subtract 38 out of 110, and 1 subtract 38 out of 110, well, that's going to be 72 out of 110. And dividing top and bottom by 2, you're going to get yourself 36 out of 55, and that is your probability, and we're done. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.